So, good afternoon to everyone. Today we are going to discuss regarding the circuit breakers concept. So, this is your 23rd lecture for the circuit breakers concept. So, in today's topic, what we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss the various classifications of circuit breakers. So, in today's topic, we are going to discuss the classification of circuit breakers. So, in the previous lectures, we had already discussed regarding the what do you mean by circuit breakers, their introduction, what is the arc phenomena, what are the various principles of arc extension involved, how we can extinguish the arc, and what are the important terms associated with the circuit breakers. So today in this topic we are going to discuss regarding the classification of circuit breakers. So there are several ways of classifying the circuit breakers. However, the most general way of classification is on the basis of medium used for arc extension. हम कौन सा मीडियम यूज करेंगे फॉर द आर्क एक्सटेंशन. मीडियम कैन बी ऑफ एयर, ठीक है. द मीडियम यूज फॉर आर्क एक्सटेंशन इज यूजली हम ऑयल को यूज कर सकते हैं, हम एयर को यूज कर सकते हैं, हम गैस को यूज कर सकते हैं, हम वैक्यूम को यूज कर सकते हैं. सो अकॉर्डिंगली डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द मीडियम यूज, सर्किट ब्रेकर्स आर क्लासिफाइड एज ऑयल सर्किट ब्रेकर्स विच एम्प्लॉय सम इंसुलेटिंग ऑयल कॉल्ड ट्रांसफॉर्मर ऑयल फॉर आर्क एक्सटेंशन. ठीक है. ट्रांसफॉर्मर ऑयल इज बेसिकली पीसीबी ऑयल. ठीक है. पीसीबी ऑयल इज पॉलीक्लोराइड बाईफिनाइल ऑयल. दैट इज द ऑयल यूज इन द ट्रांसफॉर्मर फॉर कूलिंग डाउन द बाइंडिंग्स. एंड इफ द एयर इज यूज एज अ आर्क क्वेंचिंग मीडियम, द टर्म नेम्ड इज एयर ब्लास्ट सर्किट ब्रेकर्स इन विच हाई प्रेशर एयर इज यूज फॉर द आर्क एक्सटिंग्विशिंग. इफ सल्फर हेक्साफ्लोराइड गैस इज यूज फॉर आर्क एक्सटेंशन, देन द सर्किट ब्रेकर इज नोन एज सल्फर हेक्साफ्लोराइड सर्किट ब्रेकर्स. ठीक है. द नेक्स्ट इज इफ वैक्यूम इज यूज एज एन आर्क क्वेंचिंग मीडियम, देन द सर्किट ब्रेकर इज नोन एज वैक्यूम टाइप सर्किट ब्रेकर्स. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द मीडियम यूज्ड, सर्किट ब्रेकर्स आर क्लासिफाइड एज ऑयल सर्किट ब्रेकर, एयर ब्लास्ट सर्किट ब्रेकर, सल्फर हेक्साफ्लोराइड सर्किट ब्रेकर्स एंड वैक्यूम सर्किट ब्रेकर्स. सो दीज आर दी फ्यू मीडियम्स यूज फॉर द आर्क एक्सटेंशन. ठीक है. सो ईच टाइप ऑफ सर्किट ब्रेकर्स सो दीज आर दी सर्टन सर्किट ब्रेकर्स विच वी हैड टू डिस्कस वन बाय वन इन डिटेल. सो ईच टाइप ऑफ सर्किट ब्रेकर्स हैज इट्स ओन एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस. ईच टाइप ऑफ सर्किट ब्रेकर हैज इट्स ओन एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस. सो इन द फॉलोइंग चैप्टर्स, इन द फॉलोइंग सेक्शंस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वर्किंग ऑफ दीज सर्किट ब्रेकर्स विद द स्पेशल एम्फेसिस ऑन द वे द आर्क इज फैसिलिटेटेड और आर्क इज एक्सटेंडेड. So starting with the first category of circuit breakers, those are the oil circuit breakers. So in such circuit breakers, as the name depicts, insulating material use is the oil, which is used for extinguishing the arc. So by looking at its diagram, we try to understand the real concept behind its working. So this is the diagram for the oil circuit breakers. As I had said, the circuit breakers consist of the two electrodes. One is the moving electrode, the another one is the fixed electrode. So moving electrode is moving by some mechanism that is different in different circuit breakers. So when the two electrodes get separated from each other, arc get stuck between the two electrodes. Okay. So due to this arc, the transformer oil gets evaporate or bubbles get generated. Due to that thing, the hydrogen gas, which is lighter in quantity, surrounds the whole arc like a hydrogen, big hydrogen bubble, and which pushes the transformer oil to outwards. Okay. So the arc, the final arc extension, is facilitated mainly by the two processes. Finally, the hydrogen gas has, this is the hydrogen gas bubble. So hydrogen gas bubble has high heat conductivity and cools the arc, and thus adding the deionization of the medium between the contacts. Okay. Secondly, the gas setups the turbulence in the oil, which forces the oil into the space between the contacts, thus eliminating the arc. So these are the two ways how arc is extinguished by the use of the transformer oil. So this is the whole operation, working principle of oil circuit breakers. So it has few advantages and also the disadvantages. So let us talk about the, firstly, the advantage. The advantage with the oil circuit breakers is that it absorbs the arc energy to decompose the oil into gases. ठीक है, वो absorb कर लेता है arc energy को. So why to absorb arc energy? To decompose the oil into gases which have excellent cooling properties, because when the oil decomposes, hydrogen gas bubble get generated which surrounds the arc. The hydrogen gas bubble has high conductivity, so it cools the arc naturally. Secondly, it acts as an insulator, okay, and provides smaller clearance between live conductor and earth components, which in turn increases the dielectric strength of the medium between the two electrodes. The last but not the least is the surrounding oil presents cooling surface in close proximity to the arc. Okay, so cooling surface oil provide karta hai to the arc. So the disadvantage for the oil circuit breakers as a arc quenching mediums are, it is inflammable and there is a risk of fire inside the circuit breaker. So it may form an explosive mixture with air. So circuit breaker may get at very rare chance to get explosive mixture so that it can blast. The arcing protects, due to the arcing phenomenon in the circuit breaker, the carbon get develops, which ultimately deteriorates the quality of the oil with the successive operation. So periodic checking and replacement of oil is necessary in such type of oil circuit breakers. So this is all for today's lecture. Thank you, guys.